Hey guys, how's it going? Today I'm proud to present to you brand spanking new 2017 VW, and this is going to be full in-depth tour of this Volkswagen. We'll start up, show the engine, go on some performance details, show you a bunch of the interesting features inside and out. And so guys, here's the key. Let's start the engine. Let it run for a while. Flip key, lock, unlock, and trunk button. Absolutely incredible bus. Very nicely equipped minivan for its price. Extremely reliable, very tough. Wide opening doors, it's almost like 90 degrees, providing easy entry and exit. Not bad. Two-tone interior, as you can see. Absolutely awesome interior. Solid doors, three-spoke design, fully wrapped steering wheel, your multifunction controls side to side, high gloss black finish and chrome, sport grips right here, DSG transmission, 2-liter diesel, turbo diesel engine. Very nice startup. This car comes equipped with hydraulic assist spark steering and pinion, very fluid steering wheel. This ladder feels very nice. Loud horn. Manual tilt and telescopic to adjust. Use this lever right there, it's quite easy. As you can see, alright guys, this car has automatic lights and automatic rain sensing windshield wipers right now. Lights and headlight, front air fog lights, high beam, soles are slides. Your central lock, bar mirrors left and right, use this joystick to adjust, also heated of course. By the way, huge mirrors, left and right, up and down, fully automatic windows, sweet. Alright guys, right now, let's open the hood and take a good look at the exterior of this bus. Huge handle. Lever right there to open the hood, it's quite easy. Beautiful tail lights. Rear defrosting glass and rear wiper. Third brake light. TDI, as you can see. LED license plate lights. Very bright. Single exhaust, of course. And rear parking assist. Your spare tire located underneath, right there. Of course, your tire hug. Huge VW emblem. Multi-spoke aluminum rims, 16 inch tires measuring 215/65, Hankook tires, front ventilated disc brakes, rear solid disc brakes, beautiful factory rims, very solid suspension, rear mud flaps right there. Manually folding exterior mirrors, turn signal lights on front fenders, also chrome trim, not bad. Your VIN number, right there. Huge halogen reflector headlamps. Front parking assist. Halogen fog lights. Chrome grille and huge VW emblem. Tire hug right there. This car has inline 4, 16 valve, dual head cam, 2 liter diesel engine, common rail. It produces 140 horsepower and 340 Nm of torque. Maximum speed of 172 km per hour, 0-6 time is 14.7 seconds. Combined fuel consumption for this car is around 7.5 liter per 100 km. The car is front wheel drive, and also 4 wheel drive version is available for Motion. The fuel tank is around 80 liters. Independent McPherson Strut suspension with anti-roll bar up front and double wishbone suspension with anti-roll bar out back. Main rivals for this car is a Hyundai H1 and Ford Tourneo Custom. Alright guys, right now take a good look. Take exterior, let's take a good look at the interior portion, the most interesting part. There are solid doors. Huge speakers, main speakers. Storage compartment right here. Storage area and bottle holder. Very bright LED illumination. Of course, your tire pressure. Your fuel cap right here, diesel. Seats are extremely comfortable. Adjustable headrests and seat belts. As you can see, armrest, also soft. Adjustment right here. And for this side, very nice. Seats are extremely comfortable. Storage compartment right here, seat high, sliding right there, of course, recline, not bad indeed. Storage compartment for the driver, high headlights and panel dim. You have pedals. Onboard diagnostics. Not bad. Alright guys, right now let's see what kind of noise this engine produces. And there is roughly around 2500 RPM. Fuel economy is just amazing in this bus. Awesome. E-brake is on and seatbelt warning. Sweet. Easy to read gauges, as you can see, of course, your digital clock, adjustment, odometer, your light and heat controls, plus of course your cruise control settings right here, set the speed, your intermittent wiper controls, including rear wiper, not bad. This car has 10 speakers, I believe. Sounds pretty good.
Hold tight, hold tight, chemicals collide, hold tight.
system. Mute, of course, right here. Select between different track or select between different station. Your telephone controls, voice commands, and your driver information system right there. Outside temperature, your digital clock. Alright guys, right now, let's change language. Yep. Sweet. Alright. Your consumption, range, distance, average speed, your digital speedometer, oil temperature, speed warning of course, travel time, consumption, sweet. Your audio, phone, driver alert, language, it's pretty much self-explanatory. As you can see, then your data, time adjustment, snow tires, units, temperature, Celsius, consumption, miles per gallon, tire pressure, service, and as you can see, once again, factory settings. So guys, that's pretty much it for this display. Sweet. Indeed. Overall, build quality and all the materials in this car just incredible. You can find hard touch plastic, cup holder, Twitter right here, good visibility with my 6'3" stature. This seat's extremely nice, legroom is more than enough, thigh support is pretty good, and shoulder room's okay. Extra storage compartment right here, and power supply right there, your infotainment screen, touchscreen display, disc loader, high gloss black finish, eject, mute, sound adjustment, main menu, radio, media, phone, and voice commands. Alright guys, right now I'm gonna change language. Yep, let's see. Alright, English UK. And it will take around 2-3 seconds. SD card and USB auxiliary integration. Not bad. Alright guys, main menu for your radio, band, MFM, stations. As you can see, it's quite easy to use. Very responsive screen. Manual tuning. Sweet. Your settings. Sound, scanning. As you can see, it's pretty much self-explanatory. Sound adjustment, not bad. Then your media, you can choose between CD, USB, auxiliary, Bluetooth streaming of audio, and SD card. Selection, as you can see, previous, play, next, general settings, sweet. Then phone control, voice commands. Alright, eject, mute, sound adjustment, basically your volume, as you can see, then bass, treble, mid-range, reset, then balance and fader basically. It's quite easy, very clear graphic by the way. That's pretty much it, and your main menu. Radio, media, telephone, app connect, basically Android Auto and Mirror Link. General settings for this system. Sweet indeed. Android Auto? Nope. Then your images, sound adjustment, and general settings for the system. Screen, as you can see. Then you can choose your desirable language. My keyboard language. Languages, as you can see. Data transfer, remove safely, back to factory settings, as you can see. Then Bluetooth settings, visibility, paired devices. What else we got here? Your system information, copyright info. Sweet. Configuration wizard. As you can see. So guys, that's pretty much it for this system. Easy to use indeed. Sounds pretty good. Turn it off and turn it on. Interesting bands. This car has heated seats, three-stage for the driver and for the passenger, high, medium, low and off. Here, temperature adjustment. Sync means you can control both sides. Rest, air conditioning on and off, one-touch automatic, rear. Windshield wiper is right here, rear defrost. The different modes, recycle and auto-recycle settings, it's quite easy. Passenger bay indicator right here. Turn off the parking sensors. Arc pilot, very convenient. Steering light, storage area right there and right there. DSG transmission, extremely reliable. SD card integration, reverse. Park pilot, tiptronic shifting, plus 40 upshift and minus 40 downshift, plus sport mode, of course. Sweet. Extremely smooth transmission. Reliable. High gloss black finish, as you can see. Very nice attention to the details, good sound isolation. You can definitely feel this true German quality. Good warranty, extremely peppy and reliable diesel engine, completely flat floor, and of course reliable transmission, reliable suspension, not bad. E-brake, manual dim rear view mirror, your map lights up top of course, right here, interior illumination, microphone for hands-free I believe, sun visors, vent mirror wood illumination, your card holder, grip handles up top, warning. So in general, not bad. Absolutely incredible German minivan. Love the interior as well as the exterior. Alright guys, right now let's check trunk space. With my 6'3" stature, it's quite easy to get in and out. Not bad. Trunk is huge, actually. Not bad, as you can see. Your second row and third row, sunshades, illumination up top, trunk illumination, cargo tie downs, and 12 volt power supply right there. Completely flat floor, as you can see. It's just amazing. A lot of space. And this very convenient mechanism to close trunk lid, basically. Sliding door. Very nice. Of course, third row. With my 6'3" stature, it's quite easy to get in and out, indeed. A lot of space, as you can see. Storage pocket right there and right there. Illumination, your rear vents. Quite easy to use. Amazing. Sunshades. Cut up top. And of course, child anchors right here. Out of space, quite comfortable and roomy. Central speakers and of course your armrest. Alright guys, one-hand operation. ISOFIX system. Illumination. Not bad. Child safety locks right there. It's really easy to get in and out. Nice. Storage bucket right there. Legroom is not an issue at all, and my headroom is pretty good. Climate control, your fan speed of course. Temperature adjustment right here. The different modes for the rear passengers, and one touch automatic. It's quite easy actually. Sweet system. Exquisite BW interior. Truly very impressive. And sunshade right here. Sweet. You can open this window for a band basically. Not bad. Very impressive. You can find same manual adjustment for the passenger seat. Armrest, of course, right here. Then right there. Once again, seats are extremely comfortable. Storage compartment and LED very bright illumination. Storage right there, right there, right there. Twitters. Glove box, of course, lockable. Very good size. Pen holder. Also cooled, I believe, via air conditioning. Sweet. Very nicely designed minivan, extremely reliable with good warranty, really fun to drive, true German quality, it's just what you expect from VW. Amazing bus. Well guys, hope you enjoy my in-depth look at this 2017 Volkswagen. Thanks for watching and take care guys.